was on a swivel. He was pushing the rental. Ain't it coincidental? He ain't really talking money. Who he talking? I can charge a band to get a glimpse of what I'm about to do. They be talking to every about what they ought to do. Yeah, I ain't tripping off of nothing. My name is Topic Discussion. If I give them attention, they all would probably start blushing. So power and hunt is the only thing that I'm crushing on. Bonafide, stood on everything that I stepped on.
I can get it gone in a blink.
Stack money.
We can make a from the sink.
Money.
He can make a call if you tweet.
Black money.
I can make a ball when I speak.
Rap money.
Brother used to hide a hundred. Now hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty tryna come up on the bands cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the cash at?
They couldn't see me coming with binoculars. Even if they did, tell me who the f was stopping us. The ops just keep popping up. Cops trying to lock us up. When it's out the picture, but it ain't no Diddy cropping this. Sorry, officer. I'm a hood philosopher. Then the open all the chakras up. The block is out. It ain't molten lava. Check your thermometers. These rats are synonymous. The climate's in Guatemala, bruh. Bet your bottom dollar your favorite rapper to get devoured. Sign his death certificate quick. Like sayonara, in fact. It's better if he quit and save himself a problem. He ain't got a chance to solve him. Tell me, get him any.
Gone in a blink.
Stack money.
We can make a from the sink.
Money.
He can make a call if he tweet.
Black money.
I can make a ball when I speak.
Rap money.
Brother used to hide a hundred. Now hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty tryna come up on the bands cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the cash at?
From Denver, from his end zone, here's Tre'Mond Smith. And he returns this to the 22. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. The numbers for Williams a week ago. There isn't a coach alive who wouldn't like those numbers. Well over 100 yards and a touchdown, too.
Partner, I think all the coaches are in that great coaching box in the sky would take those numbers.
So dead or alive.
Either way. it would take that kind of production.
To throw on second down, Nix. Man open, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And that's number one.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll be forced out of bounds all the way down inside the 20. A huge play there for Denver, 41 yards.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the...
They're going to have a first and goal as he's able to take this inside the 10 to the 8. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3.
Hat tip to that offensive line. Their clearance of holes, even down here deep in the red zone. And that's a nice pickup on the ground on first and goal.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Off play action. Nix out to his left. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a
touchdown. Mike Burton, his first touchdown on the year. And the Broncos will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Lutz with the extra point, and it's now a 7. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it ends with a Denver touchdown. And Davis on offense, led by their first-round pick in 2020, the man out of Oregon, Justin Herbert.
Okay, I thought there was something to build on in last week's game by his performance. I thought he played fairly well overall. The numbers won't knock your socks off. 2 touchdown passes and an interception. The bottom line, though, they lost.
Yeah.
How does he eliminate that one interception, continue to take care of the ball, and maybe increase the number of times he puts the ball in the end zone with a receiver?
On the run, this is J.K. Dobbins. And tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Here's Herbert. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have the Chargers first down, and comfortably so, as he gets 5 there on 3rd and 1 yard. A give up the middle to Dobbins. And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards. That'll bring up 2nd down. And Charles, you wonder about this defense coming in. I mean, look, it's no secret they're playing a team that's down on its luck right now. Losers of 5 straight. How does that change how you prepare for a game?
Well, to me, the first thought is you just get after them early, right? Take away any chance of them building any confidence. But the second thing is you prepare a little bit differently. You got to expect this team to take chances, go for it on 3rd and 4th downs, run a lot of trick plays, anything there.
It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Charger first. Herbert on first down now. Got an open man. It's Josh Palmer. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Charger football to start quarter number 2. As they've got it with 2nd down and less than 1 yard. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. A fake on the jet sweep and a give to Dobbins. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Right back to Dobbins on first. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Now it's Herbert. Short throw underneath to Hurst. And he's going to be taken down, but there's a penalty flag in the backfield. Is this a hold, or did they rough the quarterback? Well, Charles, sometimes we talk about the lengths officials sometimes go to protect star quarterbacks, but that one, that was tough to argue against.
Yeah, and I'm sure that everyone's going to say, hey, we're going to administer the penalty the same way for all quarterbacks. But when it's a star back there, even more so are they going to be diligent about throwing the flag.
And they give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. They'll try the air now with Herbert. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. So here's Greg Zuerlein now as he'll try for the field goal. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. Zuerlein's kick is up and through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important. Go unanswered. Took the ball to points.
Second drive offensively coming up for the Denver Broncos. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in. But I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Operating from the gun, Nix. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Sutton. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. 17 yards for the Broncos there as they've got themselves a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Looking to throw. Nix. And that's going to be caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos! Courtland Sutton hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And they're able to add on to their advantage. Lutz good on the extra point. And that push. The drive there only spanning 3 plays. And Courtland Sutton able to finish things off with the touchdown reception. Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. They set up the screen for Dobbins. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Now Herbert got to get him to the line in a hurry. from the 30 on second down. Herbert targeting Dobbins again, and he's got it again. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Herbert setting up to throw on first down. That's going to be caught. It's Palmer. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Throw left side, caught by the tight end, Hurst. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Herbert throwing again. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Josh Palmer from 4 yards out. And the Chargers get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that makes it a 14-10 ball game. Off team on the field now as they will send this one away. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Denver Broncos back out there. Former Tar Heel Javonte Williams, we shine the spotlight on him. Those are his numbers through roughly the first half of the season, and given that, you'd have to think he's on pace for a 1,000-yard campaign.
Steady as he goes, steady goes the offense, but you know what else is happening, too, because they are a team now recognized with the ability to run the football. You've got to be able to throw better now, right? Better throwing lanes, better opportunities for the guys downfield, maybe more one-on-one coverage, which you should be able to beat easier. Yeah, he's establishing not just a tone, but an identity for his team.
And that's a discussion we had a couple days ago in the team meetings, talking about this running game opening up the passing game. We'll see if that continues to happen. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. To throw. Nix. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. So the incomplete pass there, but the roughing the passer call bails them out.
Which means you have to stay on the field on defense longer because you've given the offense free snaps, not to mention the free yardage after that mistake.
Looking to throw. Nix flushed out right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. The kick by Lutz is good, and that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we have passed the halfway point of the season and now past the halfway point of this game. We skip halftime and get right back to the action. Set to begin the third quarter. One touchdown is the difference. 17-10 our score, and we are back underway on EA Sports. comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. And Charles, some things to like about that first half. Ultimately trailing here, but certainly this deficit is manageable. So curious to see what adjustments they may have made at intermission.
As am I, because I think a lot of their best reps in the first half came through the passing game. They were hitting the open receivers, taking whatever the coverage gave them and making it work well for themselves. Now, they just want to pick up the pace of scoring a little bit. So I expect them to come back, continue to throw.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man, and he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. Touchdown! Marvin Mims, 36 yards. And the Broncos are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Lutz with the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. The Charger drive about to get going.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to want to take a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, the goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit.
Up of eight. They'll go again with Dobbins. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Play action this time for Justin Herbert. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Throw over the middle, and it's caught by Johnston. And he's got this down to the 35. Holding. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that could be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got called for the penalty.
Call it a 3-yard gain, but they'll be forced into a 3rd and 15 coming up. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. He's got his big tight end. That's Hurst. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
And I believe that that gain on 3rd and 1 changes things quite a bit, because this would be a very long field goal. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go for it here.
On 4th down, Herbert. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Much more from your offense there. 1st down. Herbert operating from the red zone. And that's incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Here's Herbert. He's got his target. That's complete. From 13 yards out. And the Chargers are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and that cuts the lead to 24-17. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Broncos and Cortland Sutton heading back out there. Good day for him so far here in the third quarter. He's hit pay dirt once, over 100 yards, but hey, it's the third quarter. He's thinking, I want more, right?
He wants more, and it just increases the confidence of his team because every play he makes, that means his quarterback is really feeling good about throwing the football. Probably feels like he can't throw an incomplete pass when he throws it to him right now.
Yeah, he's looked really, really sharp. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back now to Denver. Here's a second and nine now from the 29. It's Bronco football, and they also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. So this game, Charles, you know, we talked about potential unbeaten seasons a lot. It feels like every year at some point in the season we talk about that. But this is one of those games where if you're unbeaten, you got to be careful. You can't take this one too lightly.
You're exactly right about that. And by rights, this should be a kick of sometimes happen when you think this way. So it's incumbent upon the starters to really play well to make it work for this team.
And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Broncos unable to convert here on fourth, and the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. On first and 10, it's Dobbins. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action and make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
The offense on third down tonight, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on 3rd and 2. Herbert now. Looking middle, and that's complete. And the Chargers are looking at 1st and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on 1st and goal. Edwards. Touchdown, Chargers. We are set up for a fantastic finish now. A 4th quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for 2, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
His kick is good.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And an important one that is, as we are all tied now early in this fourth quarter. If you've been waiting all day for Sunday night, it's been worth the wait. All tied here in the fourth as the kick is away. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Denver's offense now set to go. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Throwing to start the drive. Nix eluding the pressure. And he's going to go out of bounds. Gigantic loss. Kept retreating. Steps out. That goes down as a sack and a big loss of yardage.
So when the defense complains about having to do pursuit drills in the heat of training camp, plug in this play. Excellent pursuit. Force the quarterback out of the pocket. He ends up trying to run for it. Instead, he goes out of bounds and loses yardage. That goes down as a sack for the defense.
And it is incomplete. I had a defender running right with him. And now it's third down. So certainly in a pickle here. They have a mile to go to try to pick up the first. We'll see what they've drawn up. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, pulled it in. A huge play there for Denver, 49 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Back to throw. Nix flush to his right. That's complete. It's Greg Dulcich. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. They'll look to throw again. Escaping the pressure right. And this is caught for a Bronco touchdown. Marvin Mims with his second touchdown of the night. And the Broncos answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Lutz good on the extra point, and they will take a seven-point lead. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. The offense for Los Angeles returns to the field. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a seven-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. On first down, it's Herbert. Short throw underneath to Hurst. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. They'll try to draw here with Dobbins. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. If you've been waiting all day for this, this Sunday nighter's been worth the wait. It's third down here. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he takes us up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Complete.
Well, he leads the NFL in interceptions and nearly added to that total.
Got his hand on it, couldn't quite corral it. It's been a Pro Bowl-type season for him, and the term ball hawk really comes into play, doesn't it?
Yeah, I like that one a lot because teams want to avoid that type of a player, but sometimes you just can't. He just knows where the ball is.
Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four-down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
And that's the downside of taking these big shots because they're definitely lower percentage plays. And now you look up, and it's fourth down.
So not only do you have to worry about getting big yardage, you also need to just keep the game.
Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
Lutz will look to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. Herbert and the Chargers down by 2 touchdowns, under a minute 20 to go. Now their losing streak in danger of continuing as they come up on first down. Now this one complete on the slant route. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Herbert gonna throw. Pass complete, Hurst. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Here's a 2nd and 7. Throwing, Herbert. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Herbert. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Pat Surtain. And they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. Well, there's a time and a place for everything. Down 2 scores late in the 4th. I get it. Now is the time to throw it downfield, but that one might just write an end to this ball game.
Yeah, I hear all the time how critical I am of play calls. Not in this situation. No other choice, really. Look at the clock. Look at the scoreboard. Had to press it and take a chance.
Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up 2nd and 10. Williams will try again. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Chargers going to use their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
This was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence, and made it happen for a victory.
So for the Broncos, the train just keeps rolling, 9-0 now to start this campaign. And they'll get another home date next week as the Saints will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Chargers, the struggles intensify as they drop to 2-6 now on the year. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
MC Cole Kendrick and me, instead of comparing the three, let us exist in peace.